Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.3 Release Candidate, or RC. This just changes the name from GM to RC. They did that with iOS 14.2 also, and going forward, there will no longer be GM. It will just be Release Candidate to replace the name. And so they're the exact same thing. So what that means is this is the final version of the software that will release to the public as long as there's no bugs in it. So it will be the same build number unless they find something else. So we'll talk about when to expect it a little bit later, but this is available for developers and public beta testers right now. It'll come out to the public a little bit later. Now, the first thing is it comes in at 4.44 gigabytes on my iPhone 12 Pro Max and was about the same size on all of the devices here. It was over 4 gigabytes on the iPhone 6S Plus, iPad Pro 12.9, and the iPhone 12 Pro. Now, they also released iPadOS 14.3 Release Candidate, watchOS 7.2 Release Candidate, as well as tvOS 14.3 Release Candidate. There is no macOS update yet. Let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. You can see the build number is 18C65, and this will be the final build number unless they find something else, and then they'll bump it up by a number or so like they did last time. Now, the first thing is there is no modem update, at least for the 12 Pro Max, so I'm not seeing a modem update. So if you had good connectivity with 14.3 beta 3, you should with this. If you didn't, unfortunately, they didn't update that part and they didn't fix any bugs related to cellular data. But we'll talk about the bug fixes after we talk about the features. And the first thing is the new features. Now with iOS 14.3 betas, you could go into shortcuts, create a shortcut, and it would open the app directly. So if I open one here, instead of opening shortcuts and then opening the app, it just pops down that little notification every time you open it. So if you go in, it lets you know that you went through the app shortcuts to get there. So you have better customization, it will look better. And they continued that, at least on my device, with iOS 14.3. Now this update adds support for the all new AirPods Max that they announced today. Apple announced AirPods Max, which come in at $550 and have a variety of colors. They're very similar to AirPods Pro as far as their capability, but they come in space gray, silver, green, sky blue, and pink. They go over the ears, have magnetic ear cups and spatial audio and all of the things you get with AirPods Pro, but they're over the ear headphones. So it'll be interesting to try those out. Those come out on the 16th, but they're available for pre-order today. So if you go into the store, you'll see that you can order them and pick them out, whatever you'd like, and you'll get them a little bit later. And I believe they're already pushed back. You'll see it says ships 12 to 14 weeks. So they're pushed back quite a bit. Now they also announced Fitness Plus, and Fitness Plus comes out on Monday. And they said you need iOS 14.3 to use Fitness Plus. So you can see Fitness Plus's website. And if you go to the news release, it says Apple Fitness Plus will be available Monday, December 14th, and requires iOS 14.3, watchOS 7.2. So we should see those updates before then, and it's supported in iOS 14.3. So we have the Fitness app, for example, and Fitness will be able to have Fitness Plus and tracking and things like that for all of your workouts. So that's something new they've added. Now, if we go into the Health app, within Health, there's a new section. So if we go to Browse, there's new options for pregnancy, and that's all under cycle tracking. So usually it shows up for a female, not so much for a male, but it has pregnancy, contraceptive use in the Health app to better manage that. Now, as far as this particular update, it adds Apple Pro Raw, and that's only for the 12 Pro and the 12 Pro Max. So if you turn it on, you'll have the option for Raw when you go into Photos on a 12 Pro or 12 Pro Max. If you go into your settings, you can find it under, we'll go down to camera here. Under camera, you have formats, and under formats, you'll have Apple Pro Raw. You can turn it off if you'd like, but it gives you more dynamic range for more manipulation of the photo after you've taken it so you can retain more detail. And it's really nice. Another thing they added is support for video. So under recording formats, you now have PAL format. So you can record in 25p if you're over in, say, Europe, for example. In the United States, we use 24, 30, and 60 frames per second. In Europe, they use 24 and 50. So I don't see 50, but we do have 25, which is really nice that they added that. If you need that specific frame rate, it's available now. So if you want it, you'll have that option. Now, also, they've brought something back with iPhone 6S and newer. So all of the older iPhones, if you go into your settings and then you go down to the camera, we'll go down to camera. And now we have mirror front photos. This was taken away. Now it's brought back and it's on the 6S Plus and newer. So everything that supports iOS 14, it's supported in. It says 6S all the way to the iPhone 10. It's on here now. So they've brought that back. Now, something else they've been talking about for a long time that they've added has to do with privacy. So if you go into the App Store and you go to an app, we could always scroll down and have a privacy section. And you'll see it says privacy policy. However, coming very soon, we're not seeing it yet, but app developers are having to actually update this. So there's a little tag here that looks like a nutrition tag that tells about any data they might collect. So we should see these updated very soon. I would expect by the time 14.3 is released to the public, but that's something they've added as well. Now they've updated the TV app with some new sections and features. So if we go into the TV app and we tap on search, we now have TV Plus, and this can better help us find all of the TV Plus subscriptions to things like series or movies. So those are available, and they've updated search as well. So now you can search by category or genre, as you can see here, and look at all the different movies you'd like to watch. So if we go under comedy, for example, it loads and shows us comedy. So they've just enhanced it and then given us top search results to show the most relevant matches across things as well. If you search for, maybe let's try Ghostbusters, and it will give us things that are related to that as well. So you'll see they've updated search and just made it a little bit better. Now they've also updated app clips. Now app clips is something they've been talking about since the release of iOS 14, but now it's supported for launching it by scanning an Apple designed app clip code in the camera. So if I go into Safari, you'll see here's an app clip code. And if I take the 12 Pro Max, go into my camera, bring the camera over that code, it recognizes it and says no usable data found, but it recognizes the app clip code. So it recognized their special QR code, and we'll see more of these in the future, but it's finally added. And once we see more of these, we'll be able to use different apps without downloading the app. So it will make it a little bit more convenient as far as that goes. Now they've updated weather as well. And weather is updated. Sometimes you won't see all of this, but it gives you air quality information and more data about the air quality. And it's specific to certain countries as well. So for example, air quality health recommendations are available now. And you can see it says more data from Breezometer. So if we go into that, we can get more data about our local area and weather with the air quality and everything else. And it's tied into the app itself. So that's something they brought to the United States, the UK, Germany, India, and Mexico, and also mainland China for some other features. So the air quality data is available in weather, maps, and Siri for mainland China. Also, it will change based on your national scale, for example, in say Germany and Mexico. So they've updated that as well. Now, something else they've updated is a setting for Safari. So if we go down to settings and then Safari, under that we have search engine. There's a new search engine listed, Ecosia. So this is a new search engine you can use. It's not one I've used before, but now instead of just Google, Yahoo, Bing, and DuckDuckGo, we also have Ecosia added. So that's something new. And those are all the new features they've added into this particular update, along with some bug fixes as well. There are no other specific fixes mentioned for iPadOS, even though they updated. So everything you get with iOS is carried over to iPadOS as well. And there's some fixes as well. So they've fixed some things as far as bugs. The first one is people were having issues with MMS messages not being received. 14.3 resolves this, and people that weren't able to receive those messages should be able to receive them now. Also, contact groups failed to display members when composing a message. So maybe you have a large group, it wasn't showing the members when you were trying to compose that message. That's been fixed. Also, in the Photos app, if you were having issues with photos, so you'll see a bunch of photos I took here for the thumbnail and things like that. If you were having issues viewing video, for example, that will now work properly when you're sharing it. So if you shared a video, sometimes it wouldn't display properly. That's fixed. App folders from time to time were having a problem opening for some. So if you had app folders, it wouldn't pop open even from touching it. And then usually you'd reset your phone and it would work. They've now fixed that. Also, Spotlight search results and opening apps from that was sort of a problem for a while. Sometimes you'd look for an app in Spotlight search, tap on it, it wouldn't open. And now that's been resolved. So that's a nice change, of course. That's something that I've seen a lot of people complain about. And then also Bluetooth could be unavailable just in general in settings, and that's been fixed. There's other people saying that they had issues with Bluetooth as well. Hopefully that's resolved, but they don't mention it. Now, for those that use MagSafe Duo, this is just MagSafe, but if you have the new Duo charger that I showed a few days ago, it wasn't charging your iPhone at its maximum power all the time. They've now resolved that with this update. So if you have a MagSafe Duo and you have the proper charger connected to it, it should charge at the proper speed now. Now, also, wireless accessories and peripherals using the WAC protocol would fail sometimes when you were setting them up. Those should now work properly. And then there's one final fix that they've mentioned is that the keyboard would dismiss when adding a list and reminder using VoiceOver. So the keyboard would just kind of not hear what you said and then it would go away. I've seen that bug and they've fixed that now in this one. There's also security updates as well. So Apple doesn't always list every security update, but there are security updates in this. We'll probably know closer to the final release when those updates will be available or what they are as far as security, but they don't list them just yet. And so that's everything new in iOS 14.3 GM. Now, if there's anything else, of course, I'll let you know. And the final should be out hopefully later this week, probably, since we'll have Fitness Plus on Monday, or we may not see it until Monday. It's hard to say what Apple will do. Apple doesn't generally release updates on Monday, so hopefully we'll see it by Thursday or so, but if not, we'll definitely see it by Monday, according to Apple, with the release of Fitness Plus. So look for it then at the latest. And of course, I'll do follow-ups and everything else. Now, as far as overall performance, well, you saw the performance on the 6S Plus. It seems to be performing well. I haven't really had any stutters. And when using 14.3 betas, it was really fast as well. No real issues there whatsoever. The phone doesn't seem to be getting warm, and people were reporting great experiences overall. I've been using the iPad. I did have some touch issues with my iPad when I was using it with the betas. Hopefully that's fixed. Again, it will take a few days to know that for sure. But battery life overall was pretty terrible on the iPad, but good on the iPhone. So if we go into battery life on my iPad and the last 10 days, you'll see it was charged to 43% 39 minutes ago, just for this video so I could update. But 2 hours or so, I was charging it in probably getting about 5 to 6 hours of screen on time. That's not very good for an iPad. So hopefully we're back to 10. On my iPhone though, I've been using this on the beta. Let's take a look. We'll go to battery. Of course, the battery health is 100% and you don't need to worry about it degrading the battery when doing an update. It just rechecks it. You can see I got 3 hours and 11 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 51 minutes of screen off time, and I used between 50 and 75% of the battery. Now, I don't think this is terribly accurate. I've said that before because I'll go to bed and this will have 50 to 60% and I've used it all day long. And so it's only down to 60% because I've been using it heavily for this update and also installing the update and for the video, but normally it will last me much longer than that. So most people were saying 10 to 12 hours on the beta. I would expect that here. So that'll be great to see. But again, it will take a few days to know that for sure. Now, if you're on the betas, should you install iOS 14.3 RC? Well, absolutely. It's sort of our duty to figure out what's in them, if there's bugs, and report them. So the feedback app is not here. They removed it, but there is a way to report feedback still. I did a separate video on that if you want to report feedback, but either way, if there's a bug, they'll update it again. If not, this is the final version and you just have it earlier. So if they do come out with a new one, when the final one comes out, I'll let you know, of course, and tell you how to update to it at that point. Otherwise, this is the final version and should be ready to go as soon as it's released. Now, as far as the benchmarks, well, let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. I ran Geekbench 5, and on the iPhone 12 Pro Max, right after installing it, I got 1,586 for single core, 4,074 for multi-core. It usually will go up a little bit based off it finishing background processes and things like that. But if we go back and look at the history on the second, you can see it was only slightly higher with 1,590 versus 1,586 and 4,097 versus 4,074. So performance should be pretty good overall. Now, if we take a look at them on all of the devices, let's switch over to Geekbench 5. On the left, I have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. So this should give you a general idea of what your scores should be like. They should be somewhere around this and they may improve over a few days or so when it finishes doing all the background processing. Let me know if you found anything else though in the comments below. And also if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.